This morning in the Roadshow Kitchen, we are cooking with GoProvidence.com, getting tips from the pros. And today's pro is Chef Joseph Saltamaccia from the Blue Grotto. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
You have a great dish that we're making today. What is it?
Gnocchi al forno.
Gnocchi al forno. Okay. I love gnocchi. Tell us how to make it and what ingredients we'll need.
Over here we have, those are two Idaho potatoes. They're blanched, peeled, blanched, and cooled down. There's two eggs, a little bit of extra virgin olive oil, salt and pepper. And then that's type 00 flour. It's the same as AP flour, it's just ground up finer, so it makes a softer pasta. It makes it more tender, so you don't end up with gnocchi that tastes like little rocks.
All right, now you're saying they're gnocchi al forno, so what's the al forno part of it? Why are they?
Once we boil them, we're going to toss them with the sauce really quick, and then we're going to top them with fresh mozzarella cheese and bake them in the oven.
Nice. Now, you can have gnocchi as, you know, all different kinds of flavors, right? What are some of the ones you
We
can
actually make a sweet potato gnocchi as well. We put that with brandy cream sauce and fennel. That's actually going to be on the menu tomorrow, starting.
Excellent.
We'll also have these, obviously, as well.
Great. So you can definitely get these for dinner, maybe a little Valentine's date as well. You were telling me, too, that you guys are already busy getting reservations.
Yeah. Valentine's Day is going to be really busy, but I'm looking forward to it.
So should people call in now?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. Get your reservation. The Blue Grotto. And remind everyone where you guys are located.
It's 210 Atwells Ave in Providence, right on Federal Hill.
Gotta love the hill, right? Perfect Valentine's date. All right, we're going to get this started in just a little bit, get things cooking. For now, back to you.
Thanks. We are back in the kitchen, and we are making tips from, we are getting tips from the pro, Go Providence, and we're here with Chef Joe from Blue Grotto.
Yes.
And we're making gnocchi, and is it tough to make?
No, it's very easy, and that's what I'm here to show you today. So far, in this mixer right here, I put the potatoes that were already blanched, two eggs, salt and pepper, and a little extra virgin olive oil, and then I started mixing it, and I slowly add the flour until the dough comes off of the bowl, and that's how you know that it's ready. It's still a little sticky to the touch, but not very sticky. So.
And do you want it to be a little sticky? I mean,
you do, because if you add too much flour, then gnocchi get really tough.
I'll move this out anyway, just a little bit. All right, so we're going to put this. We have our
cutting board here. We got a little bit of flour and a little bit of semolina on there to stop it from sticking.
Okay.
This right here.
And then we can just put a little more flour on there. Make it easier to
match. Yeah, you don't want it to stick, yeah. So what you do is you flatten it out first, about an inch thick.
All
right. And then you start cutting these strips off here.
And that's what we'll make into smaller pieces later?
Exactly.
And
so take about three of those off.
Okay.
And then why don't you roll these out like a log.
All right, so we'll cut some of these, slice this up. How long are we going to let this dough sit for, to get to this height?
You don't have to let it sit at all, actually. There's no yeast in here.
All right, it's not going to rise, so we don't have to worry about that.
No.
All right, so
we'll
slice that up like this. And how big are we going to, how much is this going to actually make?
This will make enough for about 4 to 6 people, depending if it's an appetizer or an entree.
All right, we'll roll that out, and then we'll slice these up a little
once
more.
Once you got these rolled up like this, let me see that knife real quick.
Okay,
you just cut them just like this.
And to make it small. And how much is this going to make?
Enough for 4 to 6 people.
Oh, good. All right. So that's not bad at all.
So then once you got those cut like that, just put a little bit more semolina on there so they don't stick to each other.
So they don't stick.
And then you take this. This is called a gnocchi paddle.
Where can we get this?
probably like Williams-Sonoma, maybe Bed Bath & Beyond. I'm not really sure.
Because a lot of people will see that and panic. They're like, that's the one thing I don't have
need. If you don't have this, you can actually use a fork or the bottom of like a colander that has ridges on it.
Oh, good. Okay.
Just to put the shape on it. Yeah.
Okay.
This isn't really that important of a tool.
All right.
But you take the gnocchi on here, and what you want to do, it's like rolling a meatball, but you're holding the paddle in your hand, and then just roll it right off.
And is that's to get the ridges in it, right?
Yep.
Okay, perfect. All right, we are going to continue to make this here, get everything ready, and we'll be back in just a couple of minutes and cook some of the stuff up. Back to you.
Back in the Roadshow Kitchen this morning, cooking with Chef Saltamaccia, and we are Italian today. We're making gnocchi.
Hey. All right.
And that's it. How are we doing this?
right now, we're just going to finish the sauce. I started with about an ounce of butter in the pan.
Okay.
I'm just
going
to start to melt that. And this is our house pomodoro sauce. These gnocchis are great because you can put them with any sauce that you like.
Ooh, that
you
looks
like
good.
Bolognese.
Oh, that's
or
perfect.
Or regular tomato sauce or meatballs, whatever you'd like.
Very versatile dish.
Yeah, that's easy enough.
The gnocchis also, as you saw us rolling them in the last segment, you could actually roll those out into a sheet tray and freeze them and then put them in Ziploc bags so you can like come home, take them out of the freezer, drop them right in boiling water
and you're ready good to
like,
go. And
in
you're
like
good
10
to go.
Minutes.
And we already started, I was going to say, we already started to boil these.
And these, you know, when they're done, they'll just start to float. They look like they want to jump out of the pan. That's how you tell if the gnocchis are ready.
Okay, we can already see
some
of them. Yeah,
they're starting to move around.
Now, do these stick together? Because I know sometimes when you make pasta, you don't want the noodles to stick.
That's why when you make them, you coat them with a little bit of semolina and the flour and you lay them out out like on a cookie sheet. So they freeze individually, and then you put them back into a Ziploc bag, so they're all frozen.
So you don't get one big clump.
Okay, yeah, exactly. Gotcha. Okay.
All right.
There's the trick.
Yeah. So once the sauce comes up to a boil, I'm going to put a little bit of fresh basil.
Okay.
Yum.
And then if you want to grab that Parmesan cheese right there, I'll slide this over for you.
Grab this over here. And just grate a little bit of this in here?
Yeah. You want to go like about a quarter cup.
The name of the cheese.
That's a
or just a quarter of the cheese. I love how the name of the cheese is imprinted
on
the outside.
They brand it so you tell that it's from a certain region in Italy. It's from
Miami. Cheese is breaking up very easy.
Yeah.
It's nice and fresh.
It is nice and fresh.
Yeah. Sign of freshness.
Big hunk just came right off. But that's always okay.
That's okay, yeah.
All right.
And when we're cooking this in, what heat are we at on our stove?
It's on medium right now.
Okay.
The home stove's a little bit. It doesn't get as hot as the one in the kitchen. So if I tell you it's medium, it could be like high for.
Okay.
Right, for your kitchen.
Yeah. Let me grab this chunk.
Hey, it looks good in there.
All right, I'll leave it. I'll make sure you get that bite.
All right.
Oh, look it.
See that just about.
Our noodles are already floating at the top.
Yep.
Jumping
so
out,
grab that,
if you will.
Just grab this right here.
Drain that out.
Yeah. And these could go right into the sauce, just like this.
Oh, wow.
That looks good.
Yep.
That's so simple.
You just want to grate a little bit more cheese on top. I like when the cheese actually sticks to the fresh pasta, like in the sauce.
You're going
to
trust me with this thing?
Yeah. Well, we'll just put that whole block in there.
The whole block in there. All right, so we'll get a little more of this on here.
Yep.
And these are so simple. I mean, to me, making pasta or anything like that at home is you buy the box and you pour it in the water.
Yeah, pour it in. But I mean, this is really fresh. I mean, this looks great.
And it's simple. So is this, I mean, gnocchis seem easier to make than other kinds of
pasta. Yeah, because you don't need to deal with the machine and rolling it out to a certain thickness and trying to make the ravioli stick together after you fill them, all that stuff.
So you don't need any other pieces of equipment other than hands and that, what was that, that stone that you were using?
The paddle.
That's what it was.
And I also like the idea of being able to freeze these. So, you know, I mean, there are times when you don't feel like cooking, when you get
exactly.
home.
Mm-hmm.
You can just take them out, throw them in.
Every
and you're,
day,
and you're
right?
Good to, every day. Yes, every day.
Right from the freezer and right into the boiling water. You don't let them defrost at all. It's perfect.
Oh, wow.
And how long are we going to let this go? Now you're fancy on us.
Just until they're well coated and the sauce reduces a little bit. So these are actually good to go. We're going to go right back into this casserole right here.
All right.
Because what makes them al forno is when we bake them in the oven with the fresh mozzarella.
Okay. Step back. That looks good. Looking good.
So I'll turn that off. It's a little bit more fresh Parmesan Reggiano cheese.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
And the fresh mozzarella.
So good.
Right here. This is actually homemade mozzarella. We actually make this in the restaurant. It goes on our salad and it goes on top of the gnocchi. We make that caprese salad.
That looks fantastic.
So then we just throw these right in the oven, just until the cheese melts. You don't really have to heat it because it's already pretty hot.
Okay, what temperature is our oven at?
The oven's at 350. They take, at home it'll probably take about 10 minutes to make the cheese melt and nice and golden brown on top.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yum.
That looks good. Okay, and then we have our finished
finished
right
one,
here.
The
mashed TV. There it is. Yeah. Look at that, how it melted.
Wow!
But do you want it a little crispy on top? Is that how
just
it's
a little bit
just
crispy,
a little bit crispy on top?
Okay. And then this is just a piece of fresh basil for garnish.
Okay.
There you go, Will.
Thank you. give this a taste here.
And tell us again about your restaurant. You have dishes just like this.
Yep, this is actually on the menu. And something we're really starting to promote. Starting Friday, we're going to do $3 small plates at the bar anytime. We're going to be open from 12 noon to 10 o'clock every day. So $3 small plates is all small appetizers, small bites and stuff, and $3 wine tastes. So it's like
a
promotion.
Great.
Wow, and super affordable, too.
Oh, yeah, yep.
Come on,
this
we'll
is fantastic.
Dig in.
All right, dig in. I'm going to try it.
Take a taste.
Homemade, too. Will, did you roll out this one?
Maybe not that one. All right. This is fantastic. Thank you so much for coming in.
Thank you.
For all these recipes, you can head over to our website at WPRI.com.